In this video, we're going over puppy biting and what nobody else is telling you about it. I'm Will, your trainer here at Kindly Canine Training, and we're getting into it right now. Alright, so in this video, we're going to talk about puppy biting and what nobody else is telling you about puppy biting, and mainly what that is called ABI. And what ABI stands for is Acquired Bite Inhibition. So what we need to know about that is, number one, ABI is perfectly natural as well as absolutely necessary for every puppy. If you see a puppy and a dog playing together, what you'll most often notice is that the puppy will continuously bite the other dog, and the other dog lets it happen. When the puppy bites too hard, that dog will react and boom, and bite the puppy back. So we don't want to stop our puppies from biting. What we want to do is we want to teach them how hard they can bite. So ABI cultivates a safe, balanced dog. The number three thing to remember about ABI is it must be done in puppyhood. Once they're past puppyhood, it's too late. Whatever's built in them at that point is done and is there for the rest of their life. There is no method to alter this behavior past puppyhood. So it must be done in puppyhood. We must allow them to bite. We just need to teach them how hard they can bite. So when a dog is nom 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 and they're chewing on your hands, let them do it up until the point where it becomes pain, and then you make some kind of noise. Ah, ouch. You know, something sharp, something startling, so they know that that's too hard. And they are smart enough to know that when they're biting an adult and they're biting a child, too hard for you can be different than too hard for that child. They can learn that. So what can happen if we don't do this is our dogs can become consistently an overreactor. So every time someone accidentally steps on them, instead of yelping, you know, they will, or coming close to a bite, which is what we should see. They look in that direction, but then they go, oh, they just accidentally stepped on me, no big deal, right? So that's how it should be. If we don't allow ABI development, that puppy will either bite or become extremely fearful for every little touch or painful thing that happens to them. And that's not what we want, because those kind of dogs end up in a shelter and then eventually end up getting killed because nobody will allow a dog who bites or is extremely fearful to live with them. If you want to learn how to get rid of unwanted behaviors and bring balance back to your pack, start right now by subscribing and clicking the bell so you don't miss anything. So we need to make sure the puppies that we're adopting don't end up back in a shelter where they will get euthanized. Another thing that can happen if we don't allow ABI development is a dog may not want to interact with humans at all. So again, ABI, we must let it happen. So we don't want to teach our puppies not to bite. We just want to teach them how hard they can bite. So I'm Will, your trainer here at Kindly Canine Training. Thanks for joining me. Have a good one, and later on.